appointment official says, oh, those guys, they know they're...
The 2018-2019 Auditor General's report highlighted several concerns relating to government expenditure that need to be addressed. Today, a section of civil society groups have expressed concern over the manner in which government is handling these queries. For example, according to the report, 1.2 trillion shillings was spent outside parlementary approval. Sisi Kagab of the Anti Corruption Coalition of Uganda says government should check on such unapproved supplementary expenditure.
Now, this unapproved expenditure has been attributed by the Minister of Finance to the advice provided by the Attorney General. Now, we think that if you have supplementary budgets, these budgets are supposed to be approved as per the Public Finance Management Act.
According to Kagaba, mistage of expenditure and unaccounted for advances by local government are another form of corruption. She says such practices undermine the budget process since funds are not used for their intended purposes, leading to financial misreporting.
You have 303 million mischarged by NADS. You have 169 million mischarged by the Uganda Coffee Development Authority. You have the Uganda Tourism Board, and quite a number of other local governments have also done the same issue. Now, we need to understand that if there's a mischarge, obviously, there's no value for money because monies are doing something else that they shouldn't be able to do. And that speaks bigger volumes as to what exactly is happening.
Attachment of government funds for settling court awards is another concern for the civil society organizations. In the 2018-2019 financial year, a total of 66.5 billion was attached by way of Ganashi orders against government.
Government loses cases and they fail to pay, then the monies are going to be attached. What does this mean? That if government monies are attached, service delivery cannot happen. And again, we need to ask ourselves, why is our government continuously losing cases?
So you see it fire people as if they were relatives, you hire people as if they were sisters, and you end up in court. And when they need to pay, you begin to hesitate to pay. And somebody comes and picks a car or a chair or a computer from the office, and it is taken.
The CSOs have also advised government to desist from creating new districts and town councils since the Auditor General's report cited lack of funds and manpower to run these local governments.
You cannot say you're going to create more districts, but these same districts don't have technocrats who are supposed to bring services closer to the people. So we need to ask ourselves, is government just creating districts to bring services closer to the people, or there's something hidden when it comes to creation of districts?
Meanwhile, the CSOs are uncomfortable with some government agencies returning lots of money to the consolidated fund at the end of every financial year, since it's the same agencies that call for more funding. They say this shows inability of these agencies to plan. Ali Mivule, NTV.